Right, welcome back to the channel, and today I am talking about some black fashion designers I think people should know about. Some of the people on this list are more popular than others, but I wanted to make one video that just sheds a light on black designers, because going back to my last videos, a lot of celebrities say support black businesses and support black designers, but they don't even know who they are or support them in the first place. So I just wanted to make a video to like shine a light on some of these designers. So first I'm talking about Grace Wales Bonner. Her brand is called Wales Bonner, and she is a fashion designer of mixed heritage. So she's from Jamaica and England. And what I really like about her brand, and why I'm mentioning her first, is her brand is inherently inspired by African culture and her roots, and like the dichotomy between her British and Jamaican heritage. And she also looks to African influences in her clothes as well. Now, Grace Wales Bonner did study fashion design at CSM, and her aesthetic, if I was to put it in a couple of words, is kind of like really nice shapes, refined silhouettes, and she has a lot of embellishments on her garments, I've noticed. Because she's not popular, I'll like talk about maybe her last collection. So Grace Wales Bonner, to me, is a very, very intellectual and academic designer. Everything that she designs, there's some crazy academic research and references that goes into her collections. And in the fall, it's kind of ironic because in her fall winter collection, now obviously we know in the West, the stereotype of black people is that like, black people are criminals, black people are dangerous, and black people aren't intellectual. And Grace Wales Bonner kind of combated this in the collection. So this collection was inspired by one of the first black schools, universities in America, and it's called Howard University. So there was kind of like an inspiration from Howard University, and there was also inspiration from African culture and African heritage and history. So what she's done is she's gone through the archives of Howard University and seen how back then the intellectuals, the black intellectuals that went to that university used to dress. So stuff that's inherently American, stuff like baseball jerseys, varsity jackets, sportswear, that sort of stuff. And she's kind of twisted those silhouettes and added an African aesthetic to it, or like these African feathers, or she's gone and added embellishments on the pieces. So I thought this collection was crazy because it's shedding light that black people are intellectuals, and the black people that do go to university, like this stereotype that all black people are criminals is quite hilarious. So she's kind of used African influences in a collection to kind of portray this. And this is why I say she is so intelligent, it blows my mind. And yeah, Grace Wales Bonner, amazing designer. You have to check her out. If you want to support black designers, then Grace Wales Bonner is one of the up and coming designers that you should definitely spend your time on. All right, so the next person I want to talk about is Kanye West. I'm sure everyone knows who Kanye West is. I'll be surprised if you don't. But if you don't, he's a fashion designer slash rapper slash producer slash a lot of things. And he has a brand called Yeezy. Now, I have mixed reactions for Yeezy. The hype, and I know the focus on Yeezy, is about his collaboration with Adidas, the Yeezy 350s, you know, other silhouettes as well. I have some of them myself. But I think what I really like about Yeezy is the main line. And a lot of people give it a lot of flack. I think it's just one of those things where, because he's an artist, no one wants to give him the credit he deserves, and everyone just wants to act like Yeezy isn't a decent brand because it's Kanye West who designed it, which is kind of weird. But anyway, Kanye West, he's actually interned for brands like Fendi. So he did his due diligence and he has worked at some brands doing the lowest jobs just to gain some experience. And Yeezy, for me to describe the aesthetic, is kind of like this streetwear luxury aesthetic. The clothes look like basics, but like very high quality basics. The collections are minimalistic, which is why I really like it. I just think the pieces are kind of pricey. So for that price range, there's other stuff I would buy. But obviously, if I had a lot of money, I definitely would invest in a lot of Yeezy. And I think the footwear sets him apart from everyone else. The military boots, the crepe boots, combat boots, all the boots that Yeezy does, I love all of them. And yeah, I just think Kanye West has just been given some bad rep when it comes to fashion. I don't know why people like to discredit him so much. And it's crazy because people always discredit Yeezy, but like fast fashion brands like Zara and Topman, they copied him so blatantly when he was first making waves in fashion. So that goes to show that Kanye West has a lot of influence, and a lot of designers coming up were kind of inspired by Kanye West. So yeah, that's Kanye West in a nutshell. And the next designer I'm going to talk about now is Martine Rose. Now, this is one of my favorite designers. I own quite a few pieces from Martine Rose. She's a London designer, London-based designer, and she mainly does menswear, or I think she's just a menswear designer actually. But obviously women can wear her stuff if they want to. And her aesthetic is kind of like these oversized vintage silhouettes. And a lot of her designs are kind of like predicated on and kind of like inspired by rave culture, UK rave culture and like dance culture and stuff like that. So there's a very like vintagey, sporty aesthetic in her clothing. But if you want more information about Martine Rose, I have actually made a very, very detailed video on Martine Rose. So definitely be sure to check that out. Next, I want to talk about Virgil Abloh. So this is number four. And Virgil Abloh is a Chicago-based fashion designer. And he has a brand, he founded a brand called Off-White. And more recently, he has been appointed the head of menswear for Louis Vuitton. I have very mixed feelings about Virgil Abloh, as people know. So just to get into his aesthetic, it's kind of like this luxury streetwear as well. It's better quality materials, but basically just hoodies, jeans, t-shirts, stuff like that. Now with Off-White, it's good and bad. I would buy Off-White. So first of all, I think the women's wear is immensely better than the men's wear. So if you're a woman, then Off-White would be a good bet. But if you're a guy, I'm not too sure about that. But so with Off-White, there are some good pieces. He does make some stuff that I personally like, but I just think with Off-White, he's very inconsistent. If he makes one good collection, then we're gonna have to wait four more collections before another one's good in that respect. He copies young designers a lot. It's just not a good look. Like, it's just stuff he does that I just don't agree with. But him at Louis Vuitton, he's had some very, very, very solid collections at Louis Vuitton. They've not been groundbreaking, but they've been decent. And I think what I'm hoping is through his time at Louis Vuitton and, you know, his resources that are available to him at Louis Vuitton, that hopefully he can improve on his clothing and just get more creative and improve his designs. But an argument I hear a lot, which I've talked about a lot, is a lot of people say Virgil Abloh is not a good designer because he didn't study fashion design. But that argument, I'm not too sure about that, because there's so many good designers like Raikou Kubo who did not study fashion design but are good designers. I think he just needs to learn a lot while he's at Louis Vuitton, and we're going to get better clothes at Off-White. So yeah, but I think he's had some very good moments. One of my favorite Virgil Abloh moments is when he had that collaboration with Nike and he designed the 10 that a lot of people like to discredit, but I think that was quite creative and that was really good. Where he took 10 different silhouettes by Nike, or let me say 9, and one was by Converse, but Nike owns Converse. And he kind of like deconstructed them and reconstructed them. I thought that was a really good look. I really, really liked that collection. I thought it was really good. But yeah, that's just Virgil Abloh in a nutshell. Next, we have someone called Samuel Ross, or Samuel Ross Delano, whichever one you like to call him, SRD. And he is a London-based designer, and he owns a brand called A Cold War. Now, A Cold War, I've known for years, so many years. But I think recently it's starting to pick up steam and it's starting to become big. I think mainly because he had that collaboration with Nike. Because me personally, I know I've been wearing A Cold War for years and no one knew what it was. But once he had that collaboration with Nike, people that really went into fashion was like, oh, is this the A Cold War you've always been wearing? So I think with brands, collaborating with sportswear companies can like introduce you to a target audience and a market you never reached before. And I think that's kind of what's put him on the map. But to talk about what his aesthetic is, Samuel Ross kind of again does this luxury streetwear. From the start, he used to make tees and like joggers and stuff like that. But over time, there's been a really good progression and he's been upgrading from year to year. I know he moves production to Italy so he could get better quality garments. And I think the stuff in the past 2 years has been amazing. It has been really good. We've seen some interesting shapes, some interesting designs, and it's still streetwear-esque, but it's very luxury and I like the silhouettes. And I think A. Caldwell is quite solid. And it's quite ironic because Samuel Ross kind of was shadowing Virgil Abloh for a really long time and he learned under Virgil Abloh. And it's quite interesting because I think personally, I just prefer A. Caldwell to Off-White. So yeah, it's one of those situations where the student becomes better than the teacher. Another thing I really like about Samuel Ross's collections and A. Caldwell is recently the shows have become spectacles, the fashion shows. And I really like how he puts time and invests into the fashion shows because fashion is supposed to be kind of like performance, especially with the fashion shows. And fashion recently has been getting kind of boring. So I really like that Samuel Ross takes that aspect seriously as well. All right, so next I'm talking about a Haitian American designer and his name is Kirby Jean Raymond. And he owns a brand called Pierre Moss. And Pierre Moss is really, really sick. Kind of like, what's the aesthetic? I'd say it's kind of like, they have very refined silhouettes. The tailoring's really solid and kind of the background and what I think Pierre Moss is predicated on is it's about heritage, but at the same time activism. And I think this kind of made the brand what it is today. And I think when we're talking about collections that have put Pierre Moss on the map, I think a good collection to talk about would be the Spring Summer 2016 collection. Now in this collection, it was kind of like a political commentary on police brutality and what black people face in America. Like, you know, unrightful arrests and stuff like that. And Kirby Jean Raymond has said himself that he's actually been abused by police members and stuff. So that's what this collection was about. And in this collection, you see things like there were certain statements and the boots were bloodied. And there was even a model who was basically wearing a gun holster to kind of symbolize all the black people that have been shot by police in recent times. So yeah, I think Pierre Moss is very, very political. But I like it though, because fashion is expression, isn't it? So I like the way that his clothes have a deeper meaning and just a bunch of trash streetwear silhouettes with nothing behind them, but I just made some clothes like some people, not mentioning names, like to do. So yeah, Pierre Moss is very solid and he does speak a lot of messages in his collections. Like, I know there was another collection, but I can't remember what exact one it is, where he was talking about like mental health and how he's been affected by mental health through things he's gone through. From like police brutality and other stuff like that. So yeah, that's Kirby Jean Raymond. And last but not least is an American fashion designer that goes by the name of Shane Oliver. Now he founded the New York based fashion brand Hood by Air. Now Hood by Air is sick. Hood by Air is amazing. Honestly, I don't know what he's doing, but I'm gonna get into it. So basically, he founded Hood by Air, but unfortunately Hood by Air has been like on and off. Like some years they'll be designing and then some years he just disappears. And in recent times, he was hired as a designer for Helmut Lang. And with Helmut Lang and his work at Helmut Lang, to be honest, it's been horrible. Like Helmut Lang has been on the decline since the time he got there and slightly before he got there. And they've been designing just trash collections, like their taxi collection and other collections. And it's literally, Helmut Lang has gotten so bad that they've had to start selling their archive pieces just to make ends meet, which is terrible. So, but not talking about Helmut Lang, because Shane Oliver and Helmut Lang has been horrible, but Hood by Air is sick. Hood by Air is just amazing. There's very unique silhouettes in it. I've seen a lot of Vivienne Westwood inspirations with all the bondage stuff that they do. a lot of the stuff is genderless, very androgynous silhouettes. I like the tailoring in some collections as well. And I just love how Hood by Air, when it is working and when Hood by Air is actually alive and not dead, because Shane Oliver has gone to design for Helmut Lang, it is the it show for New York Fashion Week. And I think New York Fashion Week, no offense to all you Americans and New Yorkers, but I just feel like New York Fashion Week has been really dead recently, and it needs a buzz. It needs something like Hood by Air to like kind of have a show that people are talking about, especially because Raf Simons isn't at Calvin Klein anymore, so we don't have that show. And he has said that he's bringing Hood by Air back this year, 2019, so I'm looking forward to it, and I'm sure a lot of people are looking forward to it. And yeah, I remember some of his crazy collections, like in 2014, where at the end they had this like mad performance, or like in 2015 on the runway. I'm not sure what collection exactly it was, but I know it was like 2015, I think, where there were models in like chains, and there were models who like walked weird, and there were models who walked the runway in crutches. So he was kind of like playing and changing the fact that models have to walk so perfectly and look so perfect on the runway that we can have people on crutches too that can walk the runway and stuff like that. And Hood by Air, I'm just looking forward to it so much, coming back to New York Fashion Week. I think New York needs that. And personally, funny enough, I barely go for Fashion Week, but if Hood by Air does return to New York Fashion Week, I'm gonna try my hardest to get into that show. And I might travel to New York just for that show. So don't quote me on that, but yeah, that's something I'm definitely interested in doing. And yeah, on that note, this was just a quick fire video on seven designers, black designers you should definitely check out. Depending on how this video does, I might make a part two. So tell me any black designers that you thought I failed to mention. If I make a part two, for example, some people like Oswald Boateng, I'll talk about. And yeah, if you want more in-depth details about some of the designers in this video, like Martine Rose or Samuel Ross, I've made separate videos on them, so definitely check that out. And yeah, like, comment, subscribe. This is the Fashion Archive. I talk about fashion. The name is very self-explanatory anyway. And on that note, I'm out. Stay tuned for more. Wait, is it 2019 or 2020? It has to be 2020, surely. Jolie, put the cans in.